It's Christmas time. I'm the Vintage Collector, and these are my short Advent time stories. As a retro computing addict, it's hard to avoid dealing with floppy disk images. There's many ways to create disk images, be that general purpose imaging tools like WinImage by Gilles Volant or ImageDisk by Dave Dunfield. There's many more similar utilities like Teledisk, Cryoflox and others which I'm not going into detail today. In most of the cases, you'll come by raw sector-by-sector disk images, typically carrying .img or .ima extensions. Usually, you would transfer those disk images onto floppy disks and then conduct the install from there. But to be honest, whenever I can, I'm trying to avoid that as it's just too time-consuming. So either I'll extract the disk images and transfer the directories over, preferably via the network, a zip drive, or via serial or parallel transfer. Of course, most of the time I use WinImage to do that, but it's also possible in plain old DOS. For that, you need only the Fakedisk utility. Given you have at least 2 MB of XMS memory available, you simply run Fakedisk with the disk image file as an argument. This will load the image into RAM and redirect all access from drive A to the image file. It's very elegant, as for a software distributed on a single floppy disk, you can then run the install directly from the loaded image file. Now, you can't auto-swap images for a multi-disk install, but here's a method that works surprisingly well. Simply load up all images one by one, copying the files into a temporary directory on the hard drive. Once concluded, run fakedisk/u to free up the memory and run the install from said temp directory. Using this method, you're a lot quicker in most cases than doing the time-consuming disk transfer onto physical media. But be warned, some software simply assumes the working directory to be a:, and not just a subdirectory on a hard drive, and thus will fail to install. You may get away in some cases by using the DOS subst command to redirect the directory to a drive letter, but if you don't, you'll have to stick to real floppy disks. Anyway, I'm the Vintage Collector and this was my short Advent time story for today. Thanks for watching and see you again tomorrow.